Rick.
Sort of spawned out of a general love for old soul records, Motown, Stax and Chess and stuff like that, and then developed when we met our producer, and our producer's Brett Ballou from The Next Men. So it's got more flavours of more urban elements, hip hop and stuff like that. And the album's just an expression of those kind of influences really, and it's all linked together like a big mixtape, which is something a bit different. Hopefully people will love it, you know.
Debut album comes out on the 3rd of September, Tales from the Thames Delta, and we're extremely excited about people letting us know what they think about it. Standout tracks change from week to week at the moment, but this week it's Kimmy Kimmy.
I'm a big fan of a track called Picking Up the Pieces. It's strange because
I mean, I've been going to antenatal classes, I'm that prepared.
I haven't been doing that. The strange thing is you spend like a year, or like your whole life, they always say the old kind of adage, you spend your life writing the first album, and before you know it, it's done and out, and you're sort of developing your ideas about what you want the second album to be. You know, we're already working on the second album in terms of demoing tracks, and the first album's coming out, so you always feel like, you know, we're proud of it, it's brilliant, but we're moving on to the next thing, you know. Every time we fight, we get a little strong. We finished the tour, Rick was mentioning, we finished at the Isle of Wight and the Big Top, which was a bit of a buzz for us because, we've got a fan base, we're a band that's sort of on the rise, but you turn up to the Big Top and there's 3,500 people there, you're kind of like, what's going on?
Yeah, word spreading.
Yeah.
We got Saturday we're playing Lounge on the Farm Festival in Kent, and then Sunday we're playing Tea in the Park. This goes on. I can only think about 5 days ahead,
Yeah, the Stockton Weekender, we're doing V, we played Ibiza Rocks already this summer. So yeah, we've done loads of really cool stuff.
Yeah, it's a fun summer.
It's weird, we're one-off gigs, I suppose, because we were on the back of the tour, the Isle of Wight was just like a big gig, it was just another gig, we were drilled, we knew what we needed to do, there was no like, you know, I don't know about you, I wasn't massively nervous, you know, you just sort of go out there, because you know, as long as you know what you're doing, you don't really get nervous, it's when you know, you're not rehearsed and you don't know exactly what you're doing on stage. That's when you're nervous because you might fuck up.
If there is any nerves, it's not like a nervousness in terms of like not wanting to be there. It's just a nervousness of wanting to get it right. You know, it's not like, fuck, I don't want to do this, I don't want to go out there. It's just more like, I want this to go well and I want it to happen now. I don't want to wait for the dressing room 45 minutes. I'm going to do it now, I'm going to do it now. That's the kind of nerves that I get. We've just come off of a month-long tour. We've just had 6 days, not at home, but camped in a studio rather than moving around. So I would say we're pretty sharp at the minute in terms of the live shows, pretty well drilled. But you never know.
It could be rubbish.
Might be dreadful.
It's going to be like the album. It's all linked together. It's one big mixtape, so you turn up, and 45 minutes later we stop playing.
There's no gaps, no silence in between. It's all hopefully woven together like a medieval tapestry.
Seen too many bands where you're bored between songs.